Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So today I want to showcase a level 85 max limit break Tethys using gumi 2 account. And at this moment she is not farmable, but in the future she will be farmable. Yeah, she will get hard quests in the future, just like what it is now on the Japan version. So the first job is martial master survivor, the second job is ninja, the third job is necromancer. Basically you can use her either as martial master or necromancer. As a ninja, probably this one is only for the ninja stealth if you need extra move or extra jump for her. Okay, so the recommended passives. First of all, Polysicle is good for her. If you want higher agility, of course. If you don't need the agility, you can use Pierce and Shot and then Slash and Strike. Other than that, the ninja stealth is also optional. If you need additional move plus one, you can use this. So the passives are quite flexible, and the reaction, this one is recommended, chance of reducing physical damage received. The other ones, Poison Fog is not recommended at all, Raptio Anima is also not really that recommended, even though this one is actually not bad. And for the basic, you still can use the basic martial artist, you don't have to use the basic skills from the other one. Basic necromancy is not really that great. So okay, so basic martial arts is highly recommended for this. You can also try to use necromancer with basic martial arts if you want to, and maybe with slash and strike and polysicle like this if you want to use her as a necromancer. But at this moment, since the one that has enchant job is martial master, it is recommended to use her as martial master. Okay, so the status with Curious Doll, the max HP is 1500, not really that high, but not too low at the same time, so it is okay. The P attack is not really that high, just slightly above average, 556, so she is probably not for the damage. The martial master that has the highest P attack at this moment is Mei Fang. And the P def is not bad, 402 is quite high actually. The magic defense is very low, the agility is not bad, 139, but actually as a ninja, she can get a very high agility. It can go to 200 actually if it's fully mastered with agility 10 gear. 182 with not fully enhanced equipments like this. So yeah, her agility can be very high as a ninja, 208 if I'm not wrong. And okay, so I will only showcase her as martial master in this video because this is the one that has the enchant job. This is the one that has extra damage to human if I'm not wrong, funeral gun instead of burial gun. And this one is the enchant job skill, Sedarian survivor, strong versus human. And yeah, the gear. This one has key attack plus 50, so this is the highest in the game. Critical plus 15, paralysis 15, and agility 8. Actually, you don't really need to use agility boosting gear. If you want higher agility, you can use something like this to get agility 10. The agility will be 141, but I don't think that's needed. So higher max HP is kind of better in my opinion. So okay, let's just showcase her with this. And the leader skill, HP 30%, thunder resistance by 20% for water units. Actually, this is quite good. I mean, it can nullify the elemental weakness damage bonus from thunder unit to water. It's supposed to be plus 25%, but it has 20% thunder resistance, so only additional 5% damage from thunder enemies, which is going to make your water units stronger. Okay. So I think I should showcase her with something that boosts P attack. Okay, let's showcase her with P attack plus 50% for water units. I couldn't find the one with 30%. There is 20% like this, but not going to be that good. So let's just showcase it with 50% P attack leader skill. Let's go. Okay, the initial jewel with Wanderer's Head is 64, which means she can use any skill she wants, including the weapon ability. The normal attack to the fire enemy 1800 with Yaura's leader skill. The first skill, Destructive Palm. Physical attack strong versus machine that inflict this on single target. Range 1. The damage is 2041. Not bad. The second skill. Ogre Slaying Lance. Penetrating attack that is a physical attack strong versus monster that inflicts sleep on target unit. Range 3. This one is AoE and has 100% sleep. The damage is only 2000. Not really that high. Funeral Gun. This one is quite far. 5 range. Just like Pinpoint, but has higher damage. Much higher damage than just a Pinpoint shot. And stop 100% chance. 2400. And the other skill is Great Death Maw. Physical attack on enemy units within area around self and lowers P attack, magic attack, diamond 5. Maybe you should try this. 2600. So this one is higher than the funeral gun, but if the enemy is not in this skill's attack range, she will just going to use a funeral gun. So yeah, stomp effect is much stronger than just this AoE attack actually. And the basic skill, Sedarian Survivor. Penetrating attack that is a physical attack strong versus humans on units within target area, range 3, area line 3. This one is AoE. Oh, only 2100. Kinda lower than Funeral Gun and Great Death Maw, but slightly higher than Ogre Slaying Lance and Destructive Palm. Okay. And it doesn't have any status ailments effect, but the damage is okay, only 2100. Not really that high, honestly. And the second basic skill, Nature's Last Strength. Physical attack on enemy units within area around self, area square 3. So we have to try this. 2300. Okay. It is even better than the first basic skill, which is the Sedarian Survivor. The last two basic skills are buffs. Missile attack power, pierce attack power, slash attack, strike attack, all of these buffs gives plus 15% effect. So, for example, if I use the missile attack and pierce, she will get plus 15% boost from it. And now the funeral gun is 2500. Only slightly higher, not really that awesome. It was also for pierce, right? So the Ogre Slaying Lance is now 2200 instead of just 2000. Okay, now the weapon ability. Purging Dragon Roar. Physical attack on units within target area, range 4, diamond 5. Oh, it has to be on a straight line like this. 2500 the damage. This one is slightly higher. 2600 if I'm not wrong. This one 2400. Okay. This one is higher than the funeral gun, so if you equip her with this weapon, she might going to use this instead of the funeral gun. So if you really want her to use the funeral gun, do not equip her with this weapon, or else she is going to use this instead of the funeral gun. But yeah, this one is a very nice AoE damage. Okay, so overall, I think she is just okay. I mean, she's good, but far from OP. Yeah. In Japan, she's actually very good as a water elemental martial master, and a lot of people are actually using her on the Japan version back then. But if it's in global, I don't think she will have the spot in arena. I mean, it is because of so many people are using Roxanne, and Tethys will have super duper hard time against Roxanne, except somehow she used the funeral gun and Roxanne getting stopped. This is the only way for her to win against Thunder enemies, actually. Yeah. So her damage is just average. Maybe only slightly above average. The agility is also quite average at this moment. Not too slow, not too fast. The PDF is okay. So yeah, with the guard chance from the reaction ability, I think she is going to be quite tough, won't get killed that easily, even though her max HP is not really that high. And she is quite flexible. You can use Ninja Stealth and Polycycle if you want to get higher agility and move 4. And maybe your goal is just to do this funeral gun to the enemy if you are on the attacking side in arena. Well, other than arena, she is actually quite strong in my opinion. Yeah, maybe for the stop effect, sleep, or maybe bind and daze, or only daze without bind. Yeah. Basically, all martial monsters are good for PvE, either for the daze effect, sleep, or maybe stop. Yeah, so for PvE, she is quite good, very very usable. For arena, I think it is depend on the enemy setup. I don't think she will be good for the defensive arena, but I think she is usable if you want to use her on the attacking side of the arena. Yep, that's what I think about her. And yeah, if you're asking, is she worth the water soul shards and rainbow soul shards, my answer is no. She is going to have the hard quest in the future, so if you're a free player, getting the unit alone is already good enough, and wait for the hard quest in the future. If you're a spender and if you want to spend your gems to gather shards and stuff, it's totally up to you, but I would recommend wait for the hard quest. But if you are insisting on limit breaking her like right now, well, it is totally up to you. Okay, so that's what I think about Tethys. So yeah, thank you for watching, guys. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe now if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye bye. The Alchemist Code Global. Punch.